In this session, we will discuss Ruby laser. This diagram shows the construction of the Ruby laser. Ruby laser is a solid state laser. The active medium is a rod of a ruby crystal. A resonant cavity is formed with the help of two mirrors. One mirror is fully reflecting mirror kept at one end of the ruby rod, and the other mirror is a partially reflecting mirror kept at the other end. Laser beam output is obtained through this partially reflecting end. During the operation of a ruby laser, large amount of heat is generated. To remove this heat, water circulating system is used. Ruby laser is a solid state laser. Ruby rod is made up of aluminium oxide and chromium oxide. In fact, some of the aluminium ions in the aluminium oxide are replaced by chromium ions. These chromium ions are the active centers. That is, lasing action will occur for these chromium ions, because these chromium ions are characterized with the metastable state. This ruby rod is pink in color. Generally, in a ruby laser, a ruby rod of length 4 cm and diameter of 0.5 cm is used. The pumping method used is optical pumping. A xenon flash tube around the ruby rod provides the light energy to excite the chromium ions from lower level to higher energy levels. Only a part of this energy is used to pump the chromium ions, and the rest of the energy results in heating of the apparatus, and that's why the cooling arrangement is necessary. When light is made incident on the ruby rod, chromium ions are excited from ground level to the higher energy level E3. This energy level E3 is not a metastable state, and therefore the chromium ions will not stay in energy level E3 for long time. They will immediately fall down to the lower energy levels due to spontaneous emission. This energy level E2 is a metastable state, and its lifetime is of the order of few milliseconds. So chromium ions will stay in energy level E2 for some time, and population inversion is achieved between energy level E2 and energy level E1. Once the population inversion is achieved between energy level E2 and energy level E1, light amplification due to stimulated emission of radiation occurs, and we get a laser beam of wavelength 6943 angstroms. Ruby laser is a 3-level laser system. So, for the operation of ruby laser, energy level E1, E2 and E3, these three energy levels are involved. Lasing action occurs between energy level E2 and E1. E1 is a ground energy level, and this energy level E1 is highly populated. Therefore, the population inversion which was achieved between energy level E2 and E1 will not last forever. Population inversion will occur only for a short duration, and that's why the high power laser output will be given out only for a short duration. Once the population inversion is lost, laser output also will reduce. When the chromium ions are again excited to the higher energy level, again the population inversion is achieved and laser output will increase. Again the population inversion is lost, laser output will reduce. Again population inversion achieved, laser output increases. So, ruby laser cannot be operated in a continuous wave mode, but the ruby laser operates in a pulse mode. So, we will get pulses of the laser beam. The efficiency of ruby laser is very less. Only a part of the light energy is utilized for exciting the chromium ions from energy level E1 to E3. Rest of the light energy remains unused and results in unnecessary heat, and therefore frequent cooling mechanism is required. The power output is not a continuous one. The power output is in the form of pulses of microsecond duration. These are the applications of ruby laser. The wavelength of laser beam obtained in ruby laser is 6943 angstroms. It lies in the visible range and it is red in color. So, ruby laser can be used in various laboratory experiments. Ruby laser can be used for soldering applications and welding applications. Can be used to drill fine holes in a brittle material like glass. Can be used in interferometry, holography for creating three-dimensional images. Can be used in light detection and ranging LIDAR applications. So this is about Ruby laser.
Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to the channel so that you will get timely intimation of new videos uploaded to the channel. Thank you very much.